very much. Call everybody home. Okay, we're going to move to the second half of the program. We're going to start with Catherine Lamkin. She's going to do a presentation on art making during the pandemic. I think she's going to be at the podium. I have to say, y'all did a wonderful job on the food, too. Yeah, give a hand to all the cooks. And also, could you give a hand to all of the staff people, starting with the people who actually are in the performance or doing presentations, that they helped out, like Ty Collins back there. And we're going to save a hand for that magnificent staff of the library. We're going to save that for them. Give them a little hand. Okay, so now I'd like to introduce my wife, Catherine Lamkin, who is an exquisite sculptor, as you'll see. And also, we mentioned Winifred Sanders, and she is the mother of Catherine Sanders, and they have a whole line of quilters. I'm hoping that my daughter jumps in that line at some particular point, but she got time. She has time. Everybody give a hand for Catherine Lamkin.
Can everybody hear me, or do I need to use the mic?
You should hear you. Lenore Brown, and Lenore is a native of Charleston, and no matter what, I be lifted up, no matter what.
Thank you.
This is homegoing, and homegoing was the theme for the pneumonia festival. Each year they usually don't have a theme, but this year they had a theme, and I wanted to base my art quilt on the author of the book, Homegoing. And if you take a look at the top, and it's homegoing, it's sunlight from Ghana to Mississippi. And if you look at her outfit, on the left-hand side is actual woven kente cloth that my girlfriend who lives in Ghana sent me. She happened to watch the person as he was weaving this kente cloth. So I wanted to use that kente cloth in this piece. And then on the right-hand side, that represents the United States and Mississippi, the red, white, and blue. There is actual cotton, hand-picked cotton that is up at the top. And I always try to have a stamp when I make my pieces. And at the top, there is a stamp from Ghana. And then at the bottom, there is a stamp. It's the American Emancipation stamp. This piece is by Cassandra Allen. And it is I like the detail. If you take a look in the lower right-hand corner, the roses are fabric roses that are handmade. In the upper left-hand corner, that's a flower that was actually purchased, but you can see the difference. And if you look at the top, the woman is carrying a basket on her head, and that's one of the traditional things that they do. That's how they carry things in Africa. You know, they carry things on their head. I could never imagine myself. I guess I could learn how to do it, but to balance something on my head, that is not me. But you know that term is on your head? Just think about it. We as African American women, we have so many things. And people as human beings, we have so many things on our head, so many things in our mind that we have to deal with collectively and responsibly as well. We would like to thank all of the artists who contributed their work. Special thanks to the Charleston County Public Library, Cynthia Graham Hurd, St. Andrew Graham, the manager, Jana Stevenson, Margaret Edwards, and John Strausberg. I would also like to acknowledge Edith Miller.
National Historic Site, where I am proud to walk in the footprints of my ancestors. I often get the question, why did you go to plantations? Because that's where our people are buried.
Yeah.
And we cannot forget that. It's ownership. The spirits are there. They are still living. They talk to me. I try to talk to them. I carry this sack. It is a handmade, typical handmade sack that those rice-cultivating Africans would have had strapped on their back as they left their quarters, headed to the field to do their task. Before they left their quarters, they would take a branch and they would sweep the yard. And when they swept the yard, guess what they were doing? They were creating home security, because when they came back, they saw a footprint, or a snake footprint. They know it's not safe for the women see everything we did that we brought from Africa had a purpose. And that purpose, I tried to revitalize it in my interpretation at Littleton Place. So I carried my bag, and I have people who spend good money to come and visit a plantation. They just see this black man with this sack. And I always have a rhythm for them. Remember this?
Yes.
He made a church, so he came right out of the rice fields. And the elders had the best people. And you know why they did that? They were chasing the rice birds away, the bobolink, because that was eating up the crop. Everything we did with rhythm. Everything we did, there was a purpose. Everything we created was with our hands, and it was our survival skills. The African traditional survival skills of making do. You heard that expression? Make do. Make do. I have some examples of making do. Heard of the infield pottery, North Carolina, South Carolina? What does this look like to you? Orange juice jug. What do you do with this? You throw it in the trash. Or you might try to recycle it, right? Well, at Pendleton, we have a way of expressing cultural norms with traditional items. So we don't teach children to throw away anything, litter the environment, but to repurpose, to make value out of nothing, because that is how we evolved in this country. We created something out of nothing. So after you finish your juice, see if you can find a bottle cap. Eyes. You know what this is? You know that little thing you take off the deodorant? And then you spray it. You know what these are, right?
Cups.
Cups, yes. Yeah. Cups.
Cups.
Can't throw them away, did you? What does that look like to you?
That's the potato.
Let's put it this way. There was a time when there were symbols that represented us.
Right. I want them.
Now, how that happened? But here we have a jug, pieces cut up, bottle caps, and then you create what's called gestalt. You create your own reality out there. But these are utilitarian items, because when the enslaved people were making these jugs, it had a purpose. You know what the skull and bones are, right? Yes? What does that mean?
Poison.
Poison. Well, if this had dry measure or wet measure, you would know not to touch it. We're talking about animals. What might this be? It's another job, right? How do you interpret these things? Express yourself. Find value in what you've created. But here's what's interesting. have kids who come to Middleton Place who are homeschooled. So they don't interact with the population, if you understand what I'm saying. And then they come out to Middleton Place, and I show them something like this. Do you know what this is? This is a grapevine basket. This is a craft that children 3 to 5 years of age had to fashion after every rainfall. Mm-hmm. Same time we were learning to tie our shoes. Mm-hmm. Remember how proud we were? I could tie my shoes. Didn't want a nipple, right? So I could tie my shoes. Mm-hmm. Well, they were making baskets out of grapevine. And once they fashion those baskets, they could get eggs from the chicken coop. They could get okra from the field. They could get tomatoes off the vine and bring it back to the cook pot because everybody participated in communal life. There's value in that. But children like to play, don't they? And of course, the women were recycling all the clothes from last season. They were making rag quilts, rag, fashion, neat blankets. But the children wanted to play, so Mama made a rag ball. But guess what? The rag ball and the grapevine basket in Africa was made like this. And what do you think they were playing?
Lacrosse!
You know they came from Africa? They don't tell us anything. Yes, lacrosse.
Whoa, yeah! This is tight.
Wow.
Pass it around. Now, we asked those homeschool children to bring some plastic. So, of course, they go to Mickey D's. And they bring their straws. And so we give them an activity where they get to learn about indigo, dyeing. Some of them complain, oh, I got the blue on my hands. I say, yeah, you got the blues. That's where that expression comes from. Those people who were dying in indigo, that dye got under their nail beds, and it made them slogan. But did it matter? You had to work. We were decorating and dressing up the Europeans. Blue jeans was created on the slave plantation. Cotton dyed indigo. So these kids bring their straws. We teach them how to dye indigo. And then we take glue and the indigo rags, and wrap them around the straw. And we cut pieces and we give them a craft to do. An activity that they have to complete in the time that they're there. You know that 1 hour of instruction? Complete the work that's in front of you. And we always remember to incorporate the Native American tradition because we communicate with one another. We have a shared cultural expression in South Carolina that is indigenous and African. So this is kind of same thing, straw cut up, fabric tied onto it. And the kids make the friendship be they share. I do like the idea of talking about the survival skills of enslaved people because I happen to know that were it not for the West Africans who were brought here, who brought Africa with them, we wouldn't have Low Country Cooking. Okra, Benny seeds, something called sesame. So, when you think about plantations, think about what it is that we have given to America. We gave them an economy. Yes. and yet we are the ones who are ashamed of that contribution that we made? Some are, some aren't. But I can tell you one thing. At Middleton Place, I don't see beautiful black faces like this. And I can understand why. But I can also look in the mirror every morning when I have an obligation to go out there and do a nature walk. I am walking in the footprints of my ancestors. And with that pride, I know I'm making a contribution. The final face jug I'm going to share with you represents the divine feminine.
All right.
The divine feminine. We are because you were our mothers, our sisters, our wives. My mother was 93. I said, when are you going to stop? She said, I can't. My children are still here. And I'm almost 75, but she treats me like I'm 5. Until she comes to Middleton Place and sees me do an interaction. And then she says, proud of you, son. You didn't get education for nothing. There's value in who you are. And I thank Africa for that, and I thank you all.